We are actually starting the game, of course, and we are jumping right in. So, oh, did I actually check? Did I do the other side? I did. Oh, I did I? I did. Brilliant stuff, guys. Welcome, everybody. It's actually Clan Ma not Clan Masters. Oh, I keep saying Clan Masters. Christ. I'm gonna quickly put that scroll speed down. There we go. Welcome, everybody. It's the Arabian 1v1 Invitational, of course. We have missed game one, unfortunately, because there's been a few issues. But anyway, we're in game number two, and for those who are watching on Twitch, on YouTube, game number one will be already up on there for sure, I hope. So it's game number two, 1-0 for Bakhti after that Huns War, of course. And we're now actually into what is the setting of none Huns, mains, or Aztecs, but it's free pick of anything. And look at what we've got. We've actually got a non-mirror matchup, which I actually personally love. And well, in the blue corner, let's introduce those in players. And we've got Tyrant Bakhti, winner of game one, and he's playing as the Celts. Not exactly a surprising pick. I think we're going to see a lot of it in this first stage of the tournament, in this round robin. Celts, of course, a fantastic economy, with that wood bonus that they have. Plus, they've got an amazing tech tree for that late Imperial siege, the World Raiders, all of the above. It's a fantastic. But I will admit, in comparison to the matchup that he's got, I do think he's going to slightly struggle against the Persians, which we'll get to in just a second whilst we discuss the civs. Having a look for Bakhti's map currently, well, he's actually got a backward line to go on, which is actually very nice. For starters, he's got his secondary, sorry, his main gold right next to it too, which is actually quite handy, actually. On the front of the base, he's actually got his main stone there, and actually a full front wood line there too. It's actually also towards the back of the map as well, and that's actually quite good there at least, but when it comes to the walling, that would definitely help him for sure, and I'm pretty adamant that Bakhti's gonna wall map, and that's what he likes to do. He likes to wall generally and play quite a defensive posture. That's why it shines with mains, because that's his sort of thing. But it's actually not mains, of course. Mains is banned, so he's actually picked Celts, which could be really interesting how he's gonna play it out. He's gonna start getting that first ball. He's got four in the wood, so probably looking towards a Drush scenario coming out of this. Rest of the map though, secondary gold not too far out from his TC, and his secondary stone too. Relic not too far away, another wood line there too. And the third gold just on the far left-hand side of his base there as well, where his gold is on that hill. So just take that into account. Bringing that first ball in now as he puts down the house. And well, in the red corner, we've got Say My Name, which is actually yellow, of course, VNS yellow. He's just playing on another account, but definitely can confirm it's yellow, despite a Japanese flag. He's actually playing against the Persians, and I actually love Persian 1v1. I like playing Persians in 1v1. I like Persians in general, but Persian 1v1s are actually more fun than people think. But we'll get to that a little bit. Let's have a look at that map for him, though. He's actually got forward gold, though, on this. Well, basically, he's actually in a crater, really. Look at this scenario here. All these hills here, and his elevations do make it a little bit tricky for him, but his gold's just a lot on that hill bit. Area there, but it's okay. You can put a TC there where that wood, his wood line is actually taking, so not the end of the world. So, depending on how it all goes out, so not the end of the world on that front. It's actually got a secondary gold really close to it as well. You can see on the left hand side where his wood line is, so two close golds, not too shabby actually, and not too much on a precarious occasion. You may have to put a tower on here later on if it gets pretty messy in that feudal age, of course, when there's a lot of action going on, maybe heavy feudal war, but we'll see how that actually plans out. We actually see three in the wood for him, so looking like a scout build is going for. And I don't really blame him. I mean, he's actually got a really good map defend against the trash. It's not too exposed, very close to TC, and actually quite easy to wall. The gold might be walled out, but you're actually able to get the map control back to go onto it, so he won't consider that to be an issue at this point. Easy to wall on the left-hand side as well. He's actually got a back wood line there on this wood line too. And I can't get my chat to work on the official, so gotta give me a couple of seconds, guys, for me to fix that out, and then I can see if there's any issues I can try and fix out, basically. So the rest of the map, though, has got main stone on the front. Another secondary stone to the right-hand side as well. And his third and final gold is a little bit messy, though. It's in this sort of in this woodline here, so he can't get the full saturation. It could cause a couple of issues later on, of course. So we'll stand by and see, how that goes on later game. So right now, yellow has lived up to the feudal age, and we see that Drush inside there already from Bakhti. Third militia ready to come out, maybe a little bit too late, but the good thing coming out of this though is that Celt militia are actually really quick. That Celt infantry bonus makes it fantastic, and they can just go straight out across the map and actually get there pretty quickly. So I count out of that Drush just yet as he gets the next wood line, that villager. So whilst this Drush is coming across the map, we can actually have a little quick understanding of this Celt-Persian war. Now Persians are fantastic on the economy as well, by the way. I didn't really get to mention that in the start. Just the work rate of TC to those villagers is incredible. Get those villagers out pumping nice and fast. makes base attack economy nice and forward. And oh my god, yellow's going with a forward. I thought he was going for scouts. He's actually going for a forward, but the militia catches it out. One villager actually gets caught out here. Could go down. He's actually fighting it. The villagers are standing around in a complete circus, it seems. As three of them manage to break away from the militia. One villager's going to go back, but looks like Bakhti is actually going back on the defensive here. He wants to try and clear out these villas. And, well, one's looking very precarious on that low HP. I completely missed its forward, guys. And unbelievable. I just wouldn't expect this from... I know he likes to forward a lot, but this was bold. This was bold. Bakhti's up to feudal age 2, and he's actually fought this back. He's actually like basically made yellow force his way back. He's building a barracks back at home. He might just start to switch up his strategy and just go for a stable and start making scouts, but this is incredibly delayed and right now. The entire plan is just nowhere to be seen. Now he's starting to chop a straggler tree. Maybe he builds an archery range or something or whatever here. Somewhere not as close as he would have liked, but he's been scouted out now. So basically, Bakhti knows what's going on. And there we go. That's actually a stable. Very, very forward stable, in fact. Like, look at the distance between that. It definitely tells me that he wants to get those villagers nice and active in there. Don't know how he's actually going to do so, but we'll see how it will pan out. I'm just going to restart my Twitch. I really want to see what chat says right now about this. Four villagers going forward. Two more villagers gets added in by Bakhti. That's a really good response, actually. If you get that into Man-at-Arms too and catch out those villagers, they could definitely be GG for sure. Bakhti gets a little bit of palisades here by his cliff. Just add a little bit of extra layer of protection. Now an archer range gets thrown down too. The scout's starting to come out too. But oh, the militia have found it. The two extra ones have found it. Now I'm starting to pick out one of the militias. Man-at-Arms now upgraded coming on through. And this is getting saucy. As one villager goes down, the Man-at-Arms nearly upgraded. It's definitely start getting to work. Three scouts are actually out from Slay My Nine. Can actually start picking up these militias, but there's too much protection. One is on low HP, but yeah, not even three scouts can touch that business. He's going to definitely have to back off, that's for sure. He's definitely have to back off. Throw a bit axe now coming in from Tyrant Bakhti. He's basically 5 minutes left to walk in. Scout goes down there from Bakhti, though, which isn't that helpful. But getting some good hits on these villagers. Now, even picks up one man at arms. It's actually quite good here from Yellow. See how it pans out right now? One scout goes down, another man at arms goes down as well. Decent trade off the top, but actually, Yellow get those villagers stuck in too. Managed to actually clear out 5 man-at-arms. Did trade though a fair few scouts, but the pressure is still on though. What is Bakhti doing back at base? Well, he's putting outposts on this wood line here just to check, just in case there's any cheeky tower coming up. Just because those 4 villagers from earlier on didn't know where they were, so he wants to play it safe. Now he's also got 2 archer rangers. Skirmishers starting to pump out right now, and also a spear too to take care of those scouts, because of course the skirmishers will be very weak to this build. He needs to get those spearmen lined up, but if Yellow can actually like pick off these spearmen, then you know the skirmishers are completely exposed. And actually, this is I need to stop saying that. And well, manages to actually secure that just. I'm really surprised, but the skirmishers are actually out of position. This is not good. 2 scouts have to come in right now and start picking out those skirmishers one by one. And now Yellow starts to retreat back a little bit here, but if I'm honest. This is actually an amazing recovery here from Yellow, actually. I thought he was doomed. He managed to keep most of his villagers alive. He is a build down. But considering all, like, this isn't actually going too badly here, of course. And noting the fact that, you know, because of that town center work rate, he'll catch up on the build numbers too eventually. And actually might pull out ahead on the economy. I mean, sounds crazy, but could actually be genuinely happening here. Batching now coming in and actually just search for Bakhti. So he's actually. So now he's out of tech, but Yellow's got to definitely pull back here and regroup. Spearman's also getting stuck into it, adding a little bit of extra melee damage. They actually do, like, a fair amount, so I mean, gotta be careful, but they will, again, pick off these Celt Spearmen. So literally is back and forth between these two players right now. Bakhti playing a defensive posture here. Yellow trying to get aggressive, but he's just literally securing the middle ground here, whilst at the same time, Bakhti's actually starting to get the rest of these walls up. He's got one out of Ville here, but he will actually eventually get this all sorted out. And there he goes, just fixing all those little gaps in the wall that he had made. But so far, not too shabby here from Yellow. All is not lost. Who won MBL vs. Slam yesterday? Well, for those who do not know, spoiler. It was actually Slam. Slam won 3-1, and of course the VODs will be up on YouTube as well, probably actually, if they're not done already, definitely sure in the near future. by probably today as well. So stick around. If you haven't seen them yet, don't worry. They will be up on there. Yeah, you can always check out the rest. But people who don't have AFC's accounts, it's fine. You can ask. I mean, you know, I was just keep saying spoilers so people can just mute the stream then. But anyway, look at this. Bacti's coming on the left-hand side, though. He's actually got a fair amount of arches and a few scums just pumped in. No, it's actually just some one-shot villagers as such, but can definitely do a lot of damage to trying to take those deer. Now he's running in the opposite direction, away from his TC, towards his skirmish. Just good play here from Say My Name. I only lost one villager in the process. Not too shabby, but here he comes, though. The oncoming storm that is Bacti right now. He's going to try and go through to his main goal. Can try and pick off one villager, but here. But again, problem with these is that these skirmishes do very little to the villagers. And there's quite a large amount of skirms in this build here. So can't let you do a lot of damage. But he's actually going to go through these houses here and towards the woodline. That house is not going to save you, son. And there we go. He's got to go back round and basically run away. Actually, if I was him, I would delete the house and gone back round. But it's all in the heat of the moment, so can't blame him here. Another villager does go down, but looks like this entire army will get cleaned up. They are trapped in a corner. And now that fact that spin got taken, now the scout can start getting to work, of course. But actually, just goes down. Boom. I was like, oh, it's going to take care of it. Just absolutely instantly killed. One of those insta-kill shots. So I've actually finally got caught up with the chat now, guys. So, hi. I can now read the chat, so if I miss any important messages, just do tell me and I'll pick up on it. I'm putting a house down with those four villagers. There's another set of archers now start to come across. This mill for these deer is a little bit too insecure right now, so he's got to do something with these villagers now. I'm retasking some other part of the economy. Back to the archers now. Back to these archers trying to pick up yet another villager here, doing extremely good job. Now it's a 3-vill difference here. Bacti just sniping kills here and making basically the best of what he got here with those archers. And now he's going to try and get away scot-free, trying to pick out a skirmisher. But that's not the best idea. I think he should just literally just run away. Just be a coward. Run away. He's not a coward. He went in for a kill with a villager. And look at that. Bacti's actually up to the castle age right now. Let's have a quick look at Say My Name. He's, well, not too terribly far away, but he's definitely behind on the uptime here for sure. It's about a good 400 food away. I mean, he might drop a market and try and buy himself up for the extra gold that he's currently collecting, but this could be a long way. He's actually only getting a wheelbarrow just now, and that's pretty late if you ask me. So what is Bacti going to be doing in the castle edge? Well, the knights pretty much suck here. I don't think they're going to go for the knights. It's just going to stick the plan, keep on the ranges here, may drop a third range and just go for like 3-range crossbow and just start getting TCs up and start macroing it out, you know. Just a TC here, just have another TC maybe here as well. And yeah, looking pretty all good in the hood, actually. And of course, that TC will get a stone too, which means it enables him to get those castles up and running for those World Raiders if he wants to go for that line. But he might not actually go for World Raiders on this occasion because he's against Persians. He may decide to go for Halberdiers in case of those knights in the late game. Be a coward, what I learned from AoE. That's what I've learned. Like, honestly, just be a coward. Just run. Run bills. Run sheep. Run scouts. Run army. Anything you can. Generally, when I'm playing, like, I think, like, Black Forest, I'm normally dying, so I'm just running bills. So, stable now coming down from the same line. He's actually going to go for two stables. He's actually up to the castle age too. He's a good minute and a half behind here, really. So, he's going to be a little bit careful, but he's going to go for those Persian knights. And Persians, of course, got +2 attack against the archers, and that's fantastic. He does such a great job on the crossbows for sure. Especially if they're lacking any armor upgrades. He's got +1 armor too. But nonetheless, does extra damage, and that's the most important thing here. If he gets a good few knights, you can just wipe out most of the army here from Bacti. He's going to get the bloodlines too and scale barding armor. So these knights are going to be pretty strong. It actually probably tells me too that he's going to go for something highly aggressive. And that's well within Say My Name's nature. That is definitely within Yellow's nature to go very aggressive. And I think he has to as well. He can't let this Celts go Imperial because there are just too many weapons for him to use against the Persians, I think. I think it would just be obsolete, basically, for Persia. I'm not saying it's like, you know, Persia Imperial against Celt Imperial. That's it. It's all game over. But it's definitely leading to a good advantage in that end. So Bacti now got two town slaves. Actually got that one TC. Like I said, he would probably do it on that stone, actually. Surprised he didn't go for the wood, but he thinks he's pretty much safe. And that's, I don't actually blame him, really. I think that's probably the right decision to go for the second TC right here. Meanwhile, though, the crossbow's trying to get dirty and trying to get some bills. But, ooh, look at that quick save there on that tower. Brilliant job there. Now the knights have to come out one stable really far away. So he's going to get chain barding armor as well. And he's It makes him pretty strong, but even that mask, like, one knight is not going to do the job. He needs to get them all masked up together. And that's the problem. He's got one stable here and one stable there. And because the crossbows are in the middle, they can just start poking at one side of the other. And you can just do damage to one, do damage to the other, and then just keep microing and just be a real pest. Even a cheeky skirmisher here from Bakhti. Oh, that's a gap there. Oh, that is cheeky. I would not have noticed that. If Bakhti notices that better, like, it definitely has, because he just walked out of that skirmisher, but he can get in there and do some good damage. One knight goes down, actually, currently, but it's yellow. Not like the most ideal result. The tower there, actually lacking the bodkin, actually. To me, I think quite important knight to get, but I think he's saving on resources. He wants to get those knights out and running. He's going to clean up the rest of these crossbows that have been, well, getting down with it. I'm just throwing out many things. I don't know what it's all about, but this is beautiful. Now he knows about this little gap in the corner, as I just pointed out. He's going to try and sneak himself in here, and it's really tight as well. So when the knights come in, they can't really do as much damage because they can't get the full, like, wrap around on them. So Bakhti's going to sit himself right in here, and yellow will delete his palisades most likely. And even still, the gold there is trapping it, and there's a little bit of stone wall too. But actually, that's actually not happening. Bakhti's just backing away, but it's actually going to cross in the path of the knights, and that's not good whatsoever. Like, they don't have any attack upgrades, but they've got the plus two, remember, so it's practically having, like, iron casting on these things against the crossbows. And now here we come. Here we go. Knights are getting stuck in right now. They're going to start closing down. Bakhti, micro as best he can, managed to slide down one knight, but as I pointed, oh, wow, two knights go down. Three knights go down. Oh my god. But I still don't think this is going to... Oh my god. What is this? Hacks. Oh, come on. Persian knight? Yellow? Oh my god. Honestly, that shouldn't have happened. I shouldn't see seven knights getting cleaned up by less than 10 expos... Oh, by about 10 expos and two skirmishes. Like, that is just disgusting, quite frankly. And look at this right now as well. Two barracks getting put down by Bakhti. He knows that it's going for a full knight scheme here. He's not having none of it. He's going to start putting down two barracks. He's going to get the pikemen upgrades. And again, with Kel, that speed bonus, they can close down those knights. Because they haven't got husbandry too, quite well. I think he even got ballistics too on those. Oh my god, he got ballistics too. Oh, he's so sneaky. I love it. He must have got a university down, did he? Or those just, again, some... Yeah, he got the university, yeah, of course. Oh my god. Yeah, I know the experts have got bodkin. I meant about the bodkin arrow for the tower. I know he's got bodkin, but even still, like, plus two Persian knights? Like, come on, it's like seven of them. Like, that, like, against, like, 10 crossbows and two skirmishes? Like, that shouldn't have happened. Like, honestly. Some serious hacks coming out of here, I think, Kappa. I'm not saying he's hacking at all. I'm just jealous, basically, because that would never happen with me. So currently right now, Bakhti's pushing forward here with these crossbows, and, well, no Siege Workshop as of yet. Instead, a town center is finally coming up, actually. That's the second TC. This first, like, of them, TC's being put down here from yellow onto that main stone. There's no actual real effort to get a Siege Workshop, to even get a Mangonel out. And that, oh, nope, there it is, actually. The Siege Workshop was built over here, actually. There's that all-important Mangonel. Here comes the Mangonel shot. Ooh, quick split coming out. Bakhti right now fires a couple of volleys up too. And he's a clone, but doesn't even connect to any hits. Now the crossbows are like, let's get to work, boys, and start picking off these crossbows. Sorry, these knights one by one, but maybe I'm not sure this time around it's going to work. I think these knights... Now, I think he's actually got this finally got going now, these knights. Microing back, of course, now goes down to two knights, but actually, he's going to actually hold up relatively well here. There's a couple of skirmishers getting jumping in here to get a couple of free pickings here. And there we go. As the numbers dwindle on these crossbows, the less powerful they actually become against knights, and the knights become, of course, much stronger here. Bakhti finally getting the pikemen upgrades, he starts to spam out the spearmen. But look at the build counts right now. 82 to 50, 83, sorry, to 59. Oh, that is starting to get a little bit excessive, I think. Yellow has failed to capture this game, really. He's failed to really get, like, on the ball. Like, from this castle edge onwards. Now out comes the pikemen. No upgrades, but they're still pretty strong. Now a monk too. Oh, this is going up. Not going well. Look at the score difference too. This is not looking good. Now seeing a Siege Workshop coming out. The Celt player as well. Bakhti. And what is this coming out from yellow? It's got a bunch of villagers roaming around. Probably to try and put down a TC of sorts, but... Like, again, probably this map as well. It's very hard to TC. I really would have TC'd here. My house actually blocking a little bit. but I think he's going to try and expand the map out a little bit further on. Actually, get a TC. Oh. Oh, boy. Well, okay, the TC's not too terrible. Okay, you can say this is a bad TC, but it's not the end of the world. Like, it's going to cover the wood line, which is fine. And it kind of covers the gold at the same time. But that is not the least of my problems right now to look at, because right now, Baxi's on the way up to Imperial Age. 39 minutes, he's going to be on hitting Imperial, and it's Celt. 97 builds too. He's pretty well boomed in his Celt. He's just going to go probably Halbrand. Like, that's, for me, the most likely scenario in my head here. One that probably makes the most sense. Here we go. Second Siege Welsh are being put down right now. I'm not even sure if a lot that can be redone by Simon. I mean, he's actually got Elite Skirmish upgrade right now. It's going to get the Bodkin out, finally. Yeah, those are some Viper experts. Now, here comes those Titan getting involved right now. It's like even a converted knight there. Cheeky play by Bakhti. Yeah, those builds looking a little bit exposed as those crossbows go from there. Wrap around that wood line, and there we go. It's early season, boys. Early season. Oh, wow. Those builds actually got out. Wow. Okay, that's pretty incredible. That's pretty incredible. I wouldn't be surprised if we see a GG coming out from yellow as soon as this Imperial actually hits. And the reason why I'm saying that is just literally because of the fact that, well, what can he actually do to stop it? He's getting a Siege Workshop now down close to home because his one got destroyed. And now Woad Raider's starting to pump out too. Ooh. Bakhti. Cheeky. And Woad Raider's question. If he actually gets his fully upgraded, again, they deal with knights very well, actually, at this time. So that's fine. And also, they're extremely fast, mobile, and of course, the meaning by raiders, they'll just destroy this economy, of course. Yellows, don't just 30 up, just only came up. This game's getting way out of hand. Here's that Imperial Age upgrade, of course. Now the Halberdier comes in, first upgrade. Then the Conscription Cap Ram. There's that GG. I told you, Halb Cap Ram. That's what's going to happen. But no, we never really got to see in action, of course. GG, well played there by Bakhti, of course. The real problem in that game was just the fact that he saw it coming, and Bakhti just adopted strategy really quickly. That's a really good adaptation, I think, to the game he was playing there. He saw it, he was like, right, let's make two more militia, let's go man at arms, and let's deal with this problem here, and keep a tab on where those villagers are going, so nothing's going on. And he even built that outpost in that woodland just to check if there are any towers. I'm sorry for the flickering mouses, guys, but I'm just looking at the quick achievements here. 69 to 69. Well, that's a good number. Food, wood, no, just all economy going in the way of Bakhti. Again, not unsurprising. And of course, the build numbers too. There you go. GG, well played. I'm just going to go back out and change those scores, guys. Oh, yeah.